My dear people of God, we are going to journey with our Lord Jesus in the prayer of the Stations of the Cross. These Stations of the Cross is all about a walk with the Lord, a pilgrimage with Jesus. These 14 stations that you are about to walk is going to open the doors for you, the doors of the Lord of blessings. The blessing of the Lord shall come in. But there's a good news for you, that while Jesus walked his own stations on the cross alone, you are not going to walk alone. Jesus will be with you.
Amen.
You are not taking this journey alone. God, our Lord Jesus, is going to walk with you. He's going to walk with
you. Amen.
I can hear him saying, tell my people, I am with you.
Mm-hmm.
I am with you. This is a statement, a message of comfort, a message of confidence in the Lord. Isaiah chapter 41 verse 13 says, for I am with you. I am the Lord your God, who takes hold of your right hand and says to you, do not fear, I will help you. Do not fear, I will help you. And at the early hours of this station of the cross, the Lord is repeating the same thing to you and to me. He is telling us that he is your Lord, our God, that he will hold us with his right hand of righteousness. And he's telling you, do not be dismayed. Do not be dismayed, my people. I am with you. We are truly one in this journey. My real way of the cross, which I walked in Jerusalem on the Good Friday, from the Roman governor's court to the hill of the Calvary, and your own way this night are one. Yet, that is the difference. My life was incomplete until I crowned it with my death. Your 14 stations will not be complete until you crown them with your life. With these thoughts, may we get into this prayer of the Stations of the Cross. And as we are going, Jesus is going with us. As we are carrying the cross with Jesus, we are going to receive strength, fortitude from him. Look at Jesus. Look at him carrying the cross. Matthew 16, verse 24, he said, if you love me, carry your cross and follow me. Look at him staggering, carrying the cross. Jesus. Is he passing your way? Talk to him now. Jesus is passing this way. This way, this way, Jesus is passing this way.
Jesus is passing this way, this way.
He's passing your way now.
This way. Jesus is passing this
way.
He's passing this way tonight. Jesus is passing this way.
At him passing the way. He is coming to your street. He is coming to your city. He is coming to your address tonight. And he will not pass me by, for he is my God, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And with great joy in my heart, my people of God, I welcome you to the first station. Jesus is condemned to death. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because of thy holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
According to Mark chapter 14, verse 61 to 64, the Bible says, again, the high priest began to ask him, and they said to him, are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed One? And Jesus said to him, I am, and you shall see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the power and coming with the clouds of heaven. But the high priest tore his garments and said, what further need have we of witness? You have heard the blasphemy. But what do you think? And they all condemned him as liable to death. My dear people of God, people came forward bearing false witness against Jesus. Bearing false witness because they could not see any sin in him. The Bible said in him there was no sin. They heaped up charges against an innocent man. They cross-examined him. They could not find any sin. The soldiers flogged him without mercy, scourged him, and they crowned him with thorns. Pilate, because of fear of the Jews, condemned our innocent Savior to public execution. My dear people of God, this was the story of Jesus. What is your own story? Have you been condemned for something you didn't know about? Have you been condemned for something you never thought of? But you are carrying it. The society have rejected you. Everybody believed that you did that. You didn't know that the enemies have conspired against you. The Bible says that in the time of Jesus, they condemned him to death. And let me also tell you, maybe you have been condemned also. Maybe the reason why you are passing through what you are passing through today may simply mean that you have been condemned. Maybe you are single because you are condemned to single. Maybe you are poor because you have been condemned to poverty. Maybe you have been condemned to sickness. There are people who are sick not because it is what it's supposed to be, but because the enemies have condemned them to become sick. Because the enemies have given them that seat, that garment of sickness. I don't know where you have been condemned to. What is that situation? I tell you tonight, Jesus is going to answer in the name of Jesus. People have been condemned to death. People have been projected accidents into their life. The enemies have sent even arrows of death through accident to people. Oh, Jesus. So, people, tonight, I have a good news for you. I have a good news for you. Romans chapter 8, verse 1 is their good news. The Bible says, now there is no condemnation for them who are in Christ Jesus. There is no condemnation for them who are in Christ Jesus. So, any person that has been condemned to hatred in such a way that people will hate you for no reason, or condemned to helplessness, that no matter what you do, you feel hopeless, or you have been condemned to weakness, or you have been condemned to misery, or confusion, or profanity, whatever it is, this night, we are calling upon Jesus. Oh, to destroy that spirit. Yes, Lord, everywhere they have condemned you to shame, or have condemned you to barrenness. Oh, Jesus, let the power that in the name of Jesus come and vindicate me. For the Bible says in Romans 10, verse 13, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Are you going to call on his name tonight? Let us call on his name. Let us call on his name. Aha, Jesus, the man of Calvary. Yes, come and vindicate me. Every power, yes, that wants to condemn me, that wants to destroy me, that wants to condemn me to public shame, to condemn my children to rebelliousness, to condemn my family to lack of joy. I command those spirits now, in the name of Jesus, burn by fire. Be destroyed now. Open your mouth and pray now. Every condemnation against me, I cancel tonight. In the name of Jesus, call upon the Lord, call upon the Lord. Our Lord will fight for you. Jesus. Jesus will fight for you. The Bible says in Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 17, the Lord your God is with you, the mighty warrior who saves. He is coming to save you tonight. He is coming to fight a battle for you. Jeremiah chapter 20, verse 11 says, the Lord is with me like a mighty champion. So the Lord is both a champion and also a savior. Call on him tonight. Call on him tonight. Let him come and fight for you. That very trouble is not for me. In the name of Jesus. No matter the situation, the Lord will see me through. The Lord will see me through. Jesus. John chapter 14, verse 1. And the Bible says, do not let your heart be troubled. You believe in God, also believe in me. That is Jesus talking to you. Believe in him now. Don't let your heart be troubled, because the Lord is coming this night to come and fight for you. In the name of Jesus, every power that is condemning me, that has condemned me already, I cancel tonight. I cancel tonight. Open your mouth and pray. Call upon Jesus. Call upon Jesus. Let him arise. Lord, arise. My Lord and my Father, arise. And fight my battle. And fight my battle. In the name of Jesus. Raya Kanda Rabashiki. Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes. Cancel it. Cancel it. Cancel it. I cancel every condemnation in my life. Every barrenness in my life. Every badge of condemnation. Break into pieces right now. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We begin to cover every part of the prayer with the blood of Jesus. We cover every part of the prayer in the name of Jesus. We cover them now with the blood of Jesus. I decree, I refuse to be condemned. I reject spirit of condemnation. It's not my portion. It's not my portion. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Song.
My life is hidden in Christ Jesus. I shall live, or I shall not die. My life is hidden in Christ Jesus. I shall live, or I shall not die. I shall live, oh, 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 I shall not die. Alive, oh, I in Christ Jesus. We shall live, oh, we shall not die. Alas, hidden in Christ Jesus. We shall live, oh, we shall not die. We shall live, oh, we shall not die. You shall live, oh, you shall not die. I shall live, oh, I shall not die. You shall live, oh, you shall not die. We shall live, oh, we shall not die, oh. We shall live, oh, we shall not die.
Hi. Thank you, mighty man in battle. Thank you, God and our Father. And that brings us to the second station. The second station. Jesus carries his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus carried the cross. And he has also given us an invitation in Matthew chapter 16, verse 24, if you love me, carry your cross and follow me. My dear brothers and sisters, God has given us an invitation to carry our cross and follow him. At this point in this prayer, we are following the one who carried the cross before us, being Jesus. He has the stamina to carry cross, and he will give you the stamina to carry that cross. He will give you the strength, the grace to carry that cross. The shoulder of Jesus is a shoulder designed to carry the cross. May he help us in whatever cross he has given to us to carry as his children. May the grace be sufficient for us to carry that cross in the name of Jesus. Holy Father, many of us are carrying this cross you have given. You have allowed us to carry as a share in our journey of salvation. And Father, many are dropping their cross. Many are running away from the assignment you are giving to them. Father, we pray for grace to be sufficient. In the name of Jesus, we are using this opportunity to pray for people that in the course of carrying their cross, they are becoming despair. May God touch them and give them strength. In the name of Jesus. May God Almighty give them strength to carry that cross and they remove every spirit of despair. In the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, may you lift every despair, every burden that is on our shoulder. Oh, Jesus, we are placing them on your own shoulder because your shoulder knows how to carry the burden. Father, by lifting this despair on the shoulders of your children, may you put smiles on their faces, oh God. Father, only you can do it. The hour has come. In Job chapter 8, verse 21, your word says, oh, that you will fill our mouth with laughter and our lips with a shout of joy. Father, many have been carrying this cross with tears. Holy Father, we are praying now that you fulfill Job chapter 8, verse 21 in their lives so that their lips shall begin to be shouts of joy, so that there will be joy and laughter from their mouths. In Job chapter 5, verse 22, your word says, you will laugh at destruction. You will laugh at famine. And you need not to fear any wild animal. Holy Father, may this word and promises of yours be fulfilled also in the lives of your children. In the name of Jesus, that indeed we shall laugh at that destruction. The enemies may have been trying and packaging to bring shame into us, to bring problems into us, to make us to be weighed down by a cross the devil is packaging so that we will be crushed. But Father, you will not allow what is more than your children to come to your children. You will not allow a flood to come and carry your people. Father, you love us so much that even when you allow a challenge, a problem to come, it is to refine us. But when the work of that problem has been done in our lives by refining us, Father, we know that you begin to be glorified. But when the enemy wants to bring his own cross, which is a cross that crushes, to destroy, that destroys, Father, you will not allow that. And we are praying now, Father, that destruction, never allow it, O God. But Job 5, verse 22, as your word says, that we shall laugh at that destruction, at that famine, and we shall need not fear any wild animal. May that be our testimony today, in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you all the glory. We give you all the worship. We give you all the adoration. Give all the strength, the grace to carry this cross. For your grace is sufficient for us. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Father. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Mighty God. In the name of Jesus. Those families that are carrying cross, maybe because their children have been sick, maybe because of one problem or other in the family or in their business, Father, through this prayer, may you put a smile on their face. Remember your word and your promise that we shall laugh at that destruction. In the name of Jesus, I shall laugh at that destruction. I shall laugh at that famine. I shall laugh at that situation. I shall laugh at the barrenness. In the name of Jesus. When God gave Sarah Isaac, she now started to laugh. May God put that laughter in your life. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Song.
I have seen the light of God. I have seen the light, oh, amen, amen. I have seen the light of God. I have seen the light, oh, amen, amen. Come and see the light of God. Come and see the light, oh, amen, amen. Come and see the light of God. Come and see the light, oh, amen, amen. I have seen the light of God. I have seen the light, oh, amen, amen. I have seen the light of God. I have seen the light, oh, amen, amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Father. Thank you, our God. Thank you, our Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. And that brings us to the third station. Jesus falls the first time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My dear brothers and sisters, in the course of this, our journey, a time comes when a child of God falls. Just like Jesus carrying the cross, he found himself also falling. Reminding us that a time will come, no matter how strong we are, that we shall fall. But when you fall, the Bible tells us, the Bible invites us, encourages us to stand up and go on with the journey. Psalm 46 verse 10 says, be still and know that I am God. My dear brothers and sisters, whatever thing that is weighing you down, pulling you down in this journey, may our Lord Jesus give you strength. Give every one of us the strength to follow him. This amendment we pray through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Song.
Follow me. I will make you fishers of men. Fishers of men. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me. Follow me. Follow me. I will make you fishers of men. Fishers of men, I will make you fishers of men if you follow me.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Father. My dear people of God, and that brings us to the fourth station. The fourth station. Jesus meets his afflicted mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
As Jesus was carrying the cross, a time came when Jesus met the mother. The eyes of Jesus and the eyes of the mother caught sight of each other. It was a heartbreak for Jesus. It was also a heartbreak for the mother. Put yourself in the shoes of Mary. and see your son on the way to perdition, on the way to destruction, a way that you know that your son cannot come back to life. This is a way. Anyone that passes through this way, carrying this cross, is already a dead person. It was a terrible experience for Mary. I don't know how she survived that season of sorrow. No wonder she's called the mother of sorrows. My dear brothers and sisters. But this reminds us, many of us, having children like Mary, having Jesus as a child, we have our children on the way to perdition because of wrong influence, because of what the society has put into them, because of what the devil has used their agents to put into them. Oh, you don't know that the enemy has planted weeds in the garden, in your own garden. My dear brothers and sisters, we're here to pray that every power of the devil attacking our children, let them be destroyed. Through the attack on Jesus, may the attack on our children be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord, every spirit of sorrow that have been packaged against our family through our children, we cancel in the name of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus deliver our children. Deliver the children of people all over the world. Deliver teenagers everywhere in the world. We are praying that there shall be prayerful. That there shall be people of prayer. Oh, Jesus, may your power touch your people. Father, deliver our children. These are the children you gave to us. Father, deliver them, Lord. Let them not end up in the plots of the devil. Father, do not allow the enemy to manipulate them. Every attack against their destiny, Papa, destroy now. Papa, destroy now. In the name of Jesus. Use our children the way you use Samuel, a great man of God. Oh, the way you use David, the way you use even many prophets of the old, including Esther. Father, Lord, may you use our children in our own time to be people of God. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Father, only you that can do this. Your word says in Joel chapter 2, verse 28, then afterwards I will pour out my spirit upon all mankind. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. Holy Father, may this scripture be fulfilled in the lives of our children. Let them become prophetic children. Let them become children that their dreams will be prophetic. Children that will be dreaming of how to do the will of God. Yes, my Lord. Father, Lord, help them to grow in the love of you. Everything that wants to corrupt them or poison them, Father, destroy, destroy, destroy. In the name of Jesus. Those of them that have gone away and gone astray like prodigal daughter or prodigal son. Father, Lord, we know that even that parable of the prodigal son, that he came back to his senses and came back to his family. Father, we are praying also that every prodigal son, prodigal daughter in our families, Father, through this prayer, we are holding our hands together with one accord, with one faith, that let the miracle take place in this season of prayer. Let miracle take place that will bring them back home. That will bring their life back home. That will bring their life to Jesus. That will make them to give their life to Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, every spirit that have taken over their hearts, that have used their own hearts as a home, Father, Lord, through this prayer, let such spirits be uprooted and be paralyzed right now. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Father, send angels of deliverance to go and deliver them. In the name of Jesus. Let them begin to carry the Bible. Let them begin to carry the word of God. Those of them that are carrying guns, Father, we are taking away those guns from them. And we are giving them Bible in the spirit. In the name of Jesus. We are destroying everything, every tool or instrument that the devil has given to them. To use them as instruments to bring troubles to the society. Father, Lord, through this prayer, we are breaking, we are destroying that thing that I've been given to them, that gun that I've been given to them, that addiction to drug that I've been giving to them, that drug that I've been giving to them, we take it out of their hands in the spiritual realm. We take it out of their hands in the spiritual realm. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Father, deliver them now from the spirit of addiction. Deliver them now from the spirit of drugs. Deliver them now from the use of drugs. Father, deliver them now from bad company. Father, deliver them now. Oh, Jesus. Those of them that have refused to go to school and to be useful in the society. Oh, Father, even in the course of this prayer, I command those spirits that are causing these problems, causing this wreckage in the family, in the life of these children. Father, through the prayer, let such powers of the devil be paralyzed right now. In the name of Jesus, may the blood of Jesus begin to uproot and destroy every power of the devil against our children, against the teenagers. In the name of Jesus, we are praying now for a congregation of teenagers that will begin to serve Jesus in an extraordinary way. We are praying for prophetic teenagers. In the name of Jesus, Father, raise for us more teenagers like David, like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Those young Jewish men that refuse to bow down to the culture of the Babylonians. They refuse to eat from the table of Nebuchadnezzar because they didn't want to corrupt themselves. They didn't want to compromise their faith, Father. Holy Father, oh, even when they were put in the fire, Father, you were there with them. Even when they were terrorized, Father, you gave them boldness. Father, give us our children. Father, give us our children. We know that whatever thing we ask you that is in line with the Holy Spirit, we answered. And so we are confident that the prayer taking place now is being answered, Lord. Because we are praying the prayer you prayed. The prayer that you prayed, that they shall be one. That they shall seek you. That they shall be one with you. Even as you are one with your Father. You pray that they shall be one, we shall be one with you. Let our children be one with you, Papa. Oh, Jesus. As Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and even Daniel, stood against the culture of the time and refused to be part of the culture. Oh, so Father, we pray that in our own time, let our children never be part of the evil culture. Father, Lord, culture of lesbianism, culture of Babylonians, culture of the Egyptians, Father, we stand against them today. Our children shall not be part and parcel of them. In the name of Jesus. The culture of gay, we stand against them now. In the name of Jesus. Let our children come back to their senses, Papa. Papa, we are crying to you. Many families are in tears because the enemy has invaded the gardens of the families, invaded the character of their children, defaming such families. But now, Father, we are crying together. Father, oh Lord, release a wind that will recreate the children and give them a new heart. Father, send a wind that will bring a change of heart. In Ezekiel chapter 36, verse 26, your word says, and I will give them a new heart and a new spirit. Oh, Jesus, let there be surgical operation tonight, uprooting every spirit of rebellion in the life of the children and implanting the spirit of prayer, the spirit of love, the spirit of unity, the spirit of faithfulness, in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, Holy Father, even in their dreams, talk to them, Lord. Minister to them, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we therefore cover the destinies of our children with the blood of Jesus. Those of them who are struggling with life, Father, Lord, may you touch them now. May you touch them now. Those of them that have been rejected by society because of their principles, their lack from the family or from the church, and they decided to reject them. Father, we are praying that such children will stand in their ground to maintain their dignity and their spiritual integrity. In the name of Jesus. Father, may the pressure, especially peer pressure, never overwhelm them to the point that they will yield to the demands of society. Father, Lord, arise. Arise, Lord, and fight their battles. We are praying for them, Lord. Even the children of this prayer line and ministry, of House of Jesus and many ministries, Father, let them be exemplary children anywhere they go. Father, give them a godly spirit. Bless their prayer line. The Holy Spirit prayer line you have given to them. Oh, Jesus, bless the youth fellowship every time they gather on Saturday to make their prayer. Father, Lord, come down and be with them. Even in their classrooms, even on their playgrounds, even in their families. Father, in anything they do, in their relationships, may everything be godly. In the name of Jesus, may your presence be there. In the name of Jesus. We are praying now, any of them that is on the way to death, Father, Lord, through your prayer, let them come back. Let them come back. This is a time to come back home. In the name of Jesus, we declare this prayer time, a time of homecoming for every rebellious child. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Holy Father. We give you all the glory, all the worship and adoration. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. We cover our children and all the children of the whole world with the blood of Jesus. And those of them that are struggling with sickness, may God deliver them. Those of them that are having autism, may God deliver them. May God destroy the spirit of autism in the name of Jesus. Those of them that are having problems, health problems at the blood level, may Jesus do blood work in their life through the prayer and heal them so there shall be testimonies in the name of Jesus. Those of them that have been born and they don't have another sibling and the parents are believing God for another child, we are praying, Father, for such children that they will have another sibling. May door open because of them. Father, even when Hannah was called a barren woman, you gave her Samuel. But the moment Samuel came, the door of conception opened. The door of fertility opened. And then the mother of Samuel, Hannah, now had many other children. Father, so shall it be tonight that this prayer will open doors for conception, Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Song.
Yahweh, your name is Yahweh. You are the miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh. Yahweh, his name is Yahweh. He's a miracle working God. His name is Yahweh. Yahweh, call him Yahweh. He's a miracle working God. His name is Yahweh. He's a miracle working God. His name is Yahweh.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Father. Thank you, Mighty God. Your name is Yahweh. And that brings us to the fifth station. Simon of Cyrene helps Jesus to carry his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus, on carrying that cross, there was a time that he became weak, and he was about to expire. The executioners saw that situation, and they enlisted a passerby to carry the cross of Jesus. This man carried the cross of Jesus. This man helped Jesus to carry his cross. Let me tell you something, my brothers and sisters. Jesus is talking to us that we are to depend on each other. There is something you have that I don't have. God has done this thing in a way that he has given each and every one of us certain gifts so that each gift will complement the other. Oh, Jesus. Jesus has given the church different gifts so that we bring our gifts together to serve God. In our diversity, we have unity. Oh, Jesus. We have our beauty of worship even in our diversity of gifts. And God is talking to us to bring that gift to help the church, to support the church, to support the project of Jesus, to support the heavenly project Look at what Simon did. Simon did not expect that he would help Jesus. He was just going on his way. But all of a sudden, there was something in Simon. There was a strength in Simon that was needed to help Jesus. If Simon was crippled, you know that he would have been able to carry or help Jesus to carry the cross. So because he was able to carry that cross, means that the gift had been given to him to help Jesus. What is the gift that's given to you to help your neighbor? There is something God has given to you, which is meant to be used to bring glory to God, to support the work of God, to support the kingdom project. God is talking to us tonight. Many of us have been given the gifts of singing. And then you don't know that God has given that gift so that you use it to support the work of God, to help Jesus to carry the cross with your songs, with your gifts. And they may be asking me, Brother Wakwe, how can I use my gift to serve God? How can you use your gift to serve God? Is to pray. You pray and say, God, this gift you are giving to me, I want you to serve you. And he will lead you on the way on how to use it to serve him. My dear brothers and sisters, we are all called in different ways to serve God, different capacities and manner. But anyone who says yes, then God will start to flow through him. Many of us are called, but many of us have said no. Only if you have said yes, God is still looking for people, more people that will say yes. To say yes like Simon, whose yes was a way of him helping Jesus to carry the cross. He would have said no, but he said yes. Mary said yes when the angel came and was inquiring whether she would be available to carry, to be the mother of Jesus, to be the mother of God. She would have said no, but she said yes. She said yes by saying, let your will be done. By saying, let it be done to me according to your words. That was a statement of consent. The moment she said that, she made a consent. And then she now carried the cross. She was in labor. She had morning fever. Mary passed through all these things that women passed through when they were in labor or when they were pregnant. That was a cross. Because of the yes, she said, she carried the cross. The moment you say yes to Jesus, there's a cross to carry. Simon said yes. He carried his own cross. Now, question nine is, have you said yes? Or are you afraid of saying yes? I have met people who tell me, brother, I'm afraid of saying yes because of the challenges that go with it. But I tell you that when you say yes, even when the challenges come, even when the strength, even when it's time to cut that cross, the Lord will help you. The Lord will strengthen you. My dear brothers and sisters, as Simon said yes and carried the cross, and God gave him the strength to carry that cross and follow him. So Jesus is inviting us today to say yes to the church, to say yes to the voice of the Holy Spirit, so that we shall also, like Simon, help Jesus to carry the cross. May that God help us today to make up our mind, to use our talents, our time, and our treasure to serve God. There are three ways you can serve God. Either with your time, just devoting your time for God's work, or using your treasure, the gift that God has given to you, or using your talents. These are the ways, the three T's, you can serve God. May God help us today to use our three T's to serve him and bring glory to him. And by doing so, we are helping Jesus to carry that cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Song.
I have decided to follow Jesus. 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 have you decided to follow Jesus? Have you decided to follow Jesus? I have decided to follow Jesus. No going back, no turning back, no going back, no turning back.
There is no turning back. I am not turning back. I am following him. Day and night, I'll follow him. My dear people of God, the stage we are in this prayer is a very important stage that somebody has to make a decision that I will use my life to serve Jesus, to do his will, to do his work. And I'm inviting our sister to give us more song. As you are making that decision, may God help us. May God strengthen us in the name of Jesus. Song.
Allah can do what no other man can do. He can do what no other man can do. My Lord can do what no other man can do. He has saved my soul, I will give him praise. My Lord can do what no other man can do. He can do what no other man can do. My Lord can do what no other man can do. He has saved my soul, I will give him praise. He has given me oil of gladness. He has given me double for my trouble. He has given me beauty for ashes. He has saved my soul, I will give him praise. He has given me joy for my sorrows. He has given me double for my trouble. He has given me oil of gladness. He has saved my soul, I will give him praise. My Lord can do what no other man can do. He can do what no other man can do. My Lord can do what no other man can do. He has saved my soul, I will give him praise.
I will give him praise. In my life, I will give him praise. I will give him praise for all the talents, for all the gifts that he has invested in my life. May that God be glorified now and forevermore.
Amen.
Amen. And that brings us to the sixth session. Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My dear people of God, listen carefully. In the crowd where people were shouting, crucify him, kill him, a woman was there seeing all these things happening, and she was touched. She saw the injustice done on this man, and she was touched. She had no power to challenge the people. She had no power to take them to the court. She had no army to fight the mob. But there was something this woman did. She recognized that even though I do not have an army to save this man, at least I have something to offer. And she took her handkerchief and wiped the face of Jesus. A way of saying, be strong. a way of giving encouragement to this stranger. A little thing that she did, but this was a strength to the Lord. The thing made the Lord to turn his face and look at this woman. And for a long time of silence, that nothing, no word came out of the mouth of Jesus, Jesus had the strength to say a word, to pass a message to this woman. By imprinting his face on the veil of this woman. This woman gave Jesus a wiping of face, an encouragement. And Jesus gave this woman his holy face. Can you see? When you do a little thing, no matter how little it is, even though men might think it's insignificant, by human eyes, it might have no reckoning. But before the Lord, you have done great. This single act of this woman earned her a saint. And today we'll talk about Saint Veronica. Many of us think that it is by building a cathedral that you qualify to be a saint. No! I am here to tell you, you can be a saint by removing a stone, a pebble on the road, so it will not hurt somebody. Little things. Do you want to be a saint? Then learn how to do little things in the name of the Lord. Don't wait for when you build a cathedral. Don't wait for when you give a Thanksgiving ceremony that will attract the media. Start from where you are. That level you are now, you can make sainthood out of it. Look at what Jesus said in Matthew 25. When I was hungry, you gave me food. Something as simple as that. When I was naked, you gave me clothing. Something as simple as that. When I was in the prison, you visited me. These are not projects. These are not huge projects. These are simple things that open the windows of heaven. Do you want heaven to open for you? Do what Veronica did. Today, we are now celebrating a memorial for Veronica, for the good things she has done. And your memorial of the good you have done can also be celebrated in the future. We're asking God to help us to be an encouragement to those who are suffering. May he use us to wipe their faces, to wipe their tears. And since Jesus is the master dryer of tears, we're asking him even now to locate as many that have tears rolling down from their faces like rivers. May he wipe their tears. May he wipe your tears. Psalm 6 verse 6 says, I am worn out from my groaning. All night long, I flood my bed with tears. I drench my couch with the tears. Is that your story? May God comfort you. May he wipe your tears. Cry no more, okay? Cry no more. The Lord will see you through. The Lord will show up. He is a comforter. May he comfort you in Jesus' name. Amen. Song.
The time to save our Zion has come. We need our own miracles. The time to favor Zion has come. I need my own miracle. The time to favor Zion has come. I need my own miracle. My own miracle. I need my own miracle. I own miracle. I own miracle. We need a own miracles. The time to favor Zion has come. We need a own miracles. The time to favor Zion has come. We need a own miracles. Our own miracles. Our own miracles. We need a own miracles. Our own miracles. My own miracle. I need my own miracle. The time to favor Zion has come. I need my own miracle. The time to favor Zion has come. You need your own miracle. Your own miracle. Your own miracle. You need your own miracle.
Yes, my Lord. And that brings us to the seventh station. Jesus falls the second time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My dear people of God, listen carefully. As Jesus was carrying this cross, he found no strength again. Remember that the food Jesus left, the last food he ate was the food of the Thursday during the Paschal night, the Paschal Passover, the Passover night, the meal, the last supper. That was the last food. But even in that last supper, it could be argued that Jesus actually didn't eat that food because he knew that he was going. If you place yourself in the shoes of Jesus, would you have the appetite for food when you know that a couple of hours from that moment, your death is already at the door? You lose appetite. People in the prison, in maximum prison, who are aware that it is in the next few weeks that they will be executed, they lose appetite. They don't have drive or hunger for food again. So Jesus found himself in this kind of situation, and it wasn't the matter. From there, he went into the Gethsemane, where he spent all night, no sleep. You know how it is for you when you have all night? The next day, your body clock will be ringing. Go and sleep. Go and sleep. I need sleep. And when you deny the body that pleasure, that rest, the body will start revolting. That happened to Jesus. All night, he was sleeping. And the early hours of the night, look at a gang of mobs, enemies coming. And they arrested him. Can you imagine that kind of scenario? And then look at the man that Jesus called his own disciple, a friend, somebody who had been digging hand in the same place with Jesus, being the one to sell him, to betray him. That is more than enough heartbreak. Most people have heart shock. Most because of the fact that they discovered that this is a problem that came from their friend. It's not the same thing as when it came from an enemy. When is it from a friend? When is a friend, a brother, that has betrayed you, that have done this evil to you? It's collapsing. It is draining. It drains life. You mean you could do this to me? mean, it becomes difficult to even accept the fact. But in the case of Jesus, the fact was just there. Judas had the guts to kiss Jesus, a kiss of betrayal. Jesus was thirsty. Jesus was hungry. Jesus needed sleep. His body needed rest. But he had none of these things. And yet, he was dragged in the early morning to the Roman governor's court to be condemned. People accused him of things he never did, just to have it in the record that he did something wrong. Those people were paid. He was watching all these things. The people he did a miracle for and they delivered were now shouting, crucify him, crucify him. Is that not enough for Jesus to fall down? And so he fell down the second time. But inasmuch as he was on the ground, weak, drained of energy, devoid of strength, yet he got up and he continued the journey. By doing that, Jesus is telling you and myself, when you fall on the ground, don't lose hope. Don't lose courage. Don't become despondent. Stand up and walk and continue the journey. It takes perseverance to claim your miracle. If you give up, how will your miracle come? If Jesus had given up, how will salvation come? So he fell down a second time. And we are using this opportunity to pray for people that calamity, crisis have come for to them the second time. And people are laughing at them. They say, you married the first one. Now you married the second one again. The same thing is happening. You enter into the same business, second time again, you are failing. We are remembering them now. Let me tell you, if you have found yourself in such kind of problem, you find that it could bring a shame because people look at you as a failure. It's not that you're not doing what you're supposed to do, but the kingdom fighting you are well organized and they are fierce and aggressive. May God help you and deliver them who have been pulled the second time, who have fallen the second time. When the soldier falls, the other soldiers will help him to stand up. We pray that our fallen brothers, those who have fallen in their faith, those who have fallen in prayers, those who have lost their relationship with Jesus, who have fallen soldiers, we are praying that they stand up now. We pray for them to receive divine strength, divine glucosed, to make them strong, to receive the divine strength in the name of Jesus, to continue to run this race in the name of Jesus. May they never give up through this prayer. May the message of God be passed to them in their dreams and visions. May God begin to minister to them on the need to get back to their feet. Those brothers and sisters and close friends who have fallen, they used to pray strongly. They used to be people of prayer. They used to be prayer warriors. They used to be in the church doing the work of God. But now they are now club stars. They are now doing dirty job. They are now far away. We are praying for them. May God Almighty, through the second fall of Jesus, strengthen them and make them to come back. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Song.
It takes to serve Jesus. I speak from my heart. I will always be with you if you do your part. There is nothing this world that pleasure affords. There is peace and contentment in serving the Lord. I love him far better than in days of old. I serve him more truly than never before. I will do as he bids me, whatever the cause. I will be a true soldier and stand at my post. It pays to serve Jesus. I speak from my heart. He will always be with you if you do your part. There is nothing in this wide world that pleasure affords. There is peace and contentment in serving the Lord. I love Him far better than in days of old. I serve Him more truly than ever before. I will do as He bids me, whatever the cost. I will be a true soldier and stand at my post.
The eighth station. Jesus meets the woman of Jerusalem. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My dear people of God, while Jesus was carrying his cross and heading to Calvary, and every person was shouting, crucify him, except very few people who were there. And some of them were women. The Bible didn't tell us their names, but called them the women of Jerusalem. These women were kind-hearted. Just like Veronica, they saw that this man was not an evil man, but a great man, an innocent man. But there's nothing they could do to save him. Like Veronica, these women didn't have barrack or armies to deliver this innocent man. And so they started to cry. They were praying for this man, this stranger. They were pouring their hearts to the Lord. Weeping, agonizing. Their prayer reached heaven. You see, let me tell you, at the point in this journey, Jesus was very tired. He was staggering down the road, down the street of Jerusalem. And people were mocking him. Then these women came together. The other one talked to the other one. Hey, this man is an innocent man. Look at him. He did nothing wrong. The other one said, yes. I don't know why people are treating him this way. Very few people came together. And they were like-minded people. They were birds of the same feather. And these women started to offer prayer of tears. And when Jesus saw this episode, he had the strength to talk. Remember all this while Jesus was not talking. But when Jesus saw these women, when he saw their offering of tears, Jesus now spoke to them. Jesus tried to minister to them. Weep not for me, but weep for your children and for your children's children. As if to say, my mission is done. My work is done. This is the purpose of my coming. But what about your children? Their own work is not yet done. They need to do their own work. So pray for them. Offer these tears for them also. My dear brothers and sisters, if tears from these women would make Jesus to talk, to break a long silence, that means there is a relationship between encouragement or between prayer and strength. I repeat, it means that there is a relationship between encouragement and strength. Jesus was very tired, but this woman encouraged him with tears. This woman held a fellowship. They were praying. They were pouring tears. That was their way of praying. You know, women, they are experts in offering tears of prayers. Whether it may not even be quite prayer, tears of prayers for all that, but women, they know how to do. I don't know how, you know, maybe that part of their gifts. They know how to manufacture tears. And tears start to roll out. In this case, this was tears of sorrow. And the tears reached heaven and made Jesus talk. I am praying for you today. Let that thing that is causing you tears in your life make Jesus to talk to you. Let your tears provoke Jesus, prompt Jesus to minister to you. May he give you comfort. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. When this woman prayed for Jesus, when they were identifying with the stranger, with this man who was suffering, that gave Jesus strength. That reminds us that when we encourage one another, we give strength to one another. Most people died or committed suicide not because what happened to them was something that they couldn't overcome, but maybe there was nobody to come and pat them at the back and tell them it is well, that it's going to be fine. When you choose to go and help your neighbor, encourage your neighbor, you are doing the work of this woman. And I tell you, Jesus will talk. Amen. Jesus, Father, through this prayer, help us to encourage our neighbors, especially those who are suffering, those who are in need, those who are dilapidated, who are in danger, who are heartbroken, those who are vulnerable. Father, help us to identify with them. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Song.
Now I your blessings upon me. So I your blessings upon me, for I believe in you. So I your blessings upon us, mighty Redeemer. So I your blessings upon us, for we believe in you. Now I your blessings upon us, mighty Jesus. Now I your blessings upon us, for we believe in you. The needy are before you, the barren women are before you, my Lord. Now I your blessings upon them, mighty Redeemer. Now I your blessings upon them, for they believe in you. Now I your blessings upon us. Oh, now I your blessings upon us, for we believe in you.
Jesus. And that brings us to the 9th station. Jesus falls the third time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My dear people of God, Jesus has fallen the third time. And we need not to ask why he fell down the third time. Because the reason is already clear, that he had lost such great quantity of strength and had fallen down. Many a time in the journey of our faith, because of the attacks, sometimes we lose courage. Jesus considered that even the people doing all these things against him were his own people. These were not foreigners. His own people. People he could call his own brothers and sisters. They were the ones fighting him. Household wickedness. Many of us are under the attack of household wickedness. The war in the house. Our people say that it is the rat in the house that told the rat outside the house that there's a fish in the house. This was a situation that Jesus found himself. His own people rejected him. His own people conspired against him. His own people oppressed him. The worst injustice in human history was against Jesus. Hello, Jesus. My dear people of God, Jesus, having fallen the third time, did not give up. He also continued to journey. And he's talking to you and talking to me tonight. In John chapter 14, verse 1. Do not let your heart be troubled. You believe in God, also believe in me. When you fall, look unto Jesus. And you get strength. If you believe in him, if you trust in him, you will stand. Those who kneel before him, they get strength. You see, that's the power of kneeling down, the power of prayer. When you fall down, when people betray you, when friends betray you, when things are falling apart, when your life is in fragments, when it appears as if tornado and the hurricane and the earthquake have gathered to come and visit you, and there's no more hope, look unto Jesus. You will get the strength to tell the story. He will make a message out of that mess. Those who have come to understand that secret, they get connected to Jesus. They seek him in prayer. Every time they are in prayer. Jesus. Most of us, if we look at our knees are looking very, very clean. If you have the culture of kneeling down all the time, your knee will be dark because of the pressure on it. Use your knees for prayer. I'm not saying that you must kneel down before you communicate with God or to God. But the fact is that whether you are doing it figuratively or you are doing it literally, God wants us to talk to him in prayer. God wants us to derive strength from him through prayer. When you fall, you stand up. About 4 years ago, somebody told me a story of a rich man who borrowed a lot of money from the bank and ordered a lot of goods overseas, but the ship sank in the ocean. He heard about it, and he quickly committed suicide. He told himself, I cannot be alive to see this happen. So, Jesus, because he gave up, meaning that he did not trust in God. It is not over until Jesus says it is over. When you fall down, even if you fall down a second time, or like Jesus, you fall down a third time, do not give up. Do not let your heart be troubled. Jesus knows that someday you will fall. whether it is sin that is making you to fall, or whether it is attacks of the devil that is making you to fall, the answer is seek the face of the Lord. If you seek his face, you'll find him. Jeremiah 29, verse 13 says, thou shalt seek me with all your heart, and thou shalt find me. David fell down to sin. When he killed the husband of the woman he was interested in, that was a great atrocity. And yet God said, this is a man after my eyes. What's the secret? Because David knew how to get up and seek the face of the Lord and confess his sins and ask God to have mercy on him. And he knew that God would always forgive him. Even if there is a sin in your life that you are struggling to overcome, but yet, as soon as you are going to confession, you are going back to it again. Second time, third time, fourth time, 70 times, 30 times. Don't give up. Look unto the Lord. The strength of the righteous comes from the Lord. Know what David said? The Lord is my strength and my salvation. John chapter 16, verse 33 says, these things I have spoken unto you, that in me you might have peace. In the world you shall have troubles, you shall have tribulations, you shall be persecuted. But be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. Jesus has overcome the world for you. So even that problem Jesus has already overcome it. And Jesus is telling us in 1 John chapter 5, verse 4, that whosoever is born of God is an overcomer. Do you know there is an overcomer's anointing in you? In your DNA, there is overcomer signature that is there. A signature implanted in you divinely to make you to be an overcomer. Overcomer of obstacles. Overcomer of mountains. The devil knows about that. That DNA of overcomer used to be in a DNA in the enemy, Satan himself, but he lost it when he rebelled in heaven. He knows that you have that signature in your DNA, and he's fighting you. But when you know the character of Christ in you, you will defeat the devil. And Jesus, our elder brother, has come to mesmerize the devil. 1 John chapter 3 verse 8 says, for this reason, Jesus was made manifest that he shall destroy the works of the devil. Therefore, every work of the devil pulling you down, pushing you down, push it on your business, push it on your health, push it on your relationships, scattering your testimonies. We command them now in the name of Jesus. Let them be destroyed now. Let them be destroyed now by fire, by fire. Let them be destroyed now in the name of Jesus. Let them burn into pieces in the name of Jesus. Tell yourself, I will make it. Tell yourself, even though I've fallen, but I'm getting up now, not tomorrow. Decide now to continue this journey. May God give you that strength in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Song.
I prayed. Lord Jesus answered me. I prayed. Lord Jesus answered me, it is well with my soul. We praise, Lord Jesus answered us. We praise, Lord Jesus answered us. It is well with our souls.
The tenth station, Jesus is stripped of his clothes. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
At a point on the cross of Calvary, on the mountain of Calvary, they stripped Jesus naked. They stripped our leader, our God, our Messiah naked. This is a mystery. That the God who made heaven and earth, made all the galaxies, all the solar system, the God who gave us hands, that the hands of his creatures are now making him naked. That is, God gave us the gift of hands, but now, through the works of our hands, we are making him naked. Does it make sense? Without those hands, those people would have made Jesus naked. Because they needed a hand to make Jesus naked. But now, Jesus has given them the gift of the hand, making their hands not to be feeble or not to be disabled or amputated. Now, the way of saying thank you for this you have done for us is to use the hands to make Jesus naked. Is that good? Of course, you tell me no. But by the way, in many ways, we use our hands, even today, to make Jesus naked. What kind of cloth do you wear? You wear the cloth with your hand. You use your hand to give the money to buy it. And these clothes are as well making you naked. The fact remains that God sees our body as a temple of the Holy Spirit. And when we do not honor our body, how can we say we have not made Jesus naked? My dear brothers and sisters, we're asking the Lord to help us to use our hands to bring glory to God, not to bring shame. These people use their hands to bring shame to Jesus. And we're asking Jesus to help us never to use our hands or our lives to bring shame to Jesus. May God forbid that in Jesus' name. May God help us to use our hands to bring glory to him in the name of Jesus. May he use our hands to restore the dignity of man in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. We also remember people who are naked spiritually. May God wear them the garment of life, the garment of restoration. May God fight for them. Families that are naked, maybe love has gone. That is naked. Maybe financial nakedness. Maybe relationship nakedness. I don't know what is the naked or nudity in your life through this striping of Jesus' clothes. May he clothe you. Jesus was stripped naked that we shall be clothed. He was made shame that we shall have pride, dignity. In the name of the Father, and Son, and Holy Spirit, may that dignity of man be restored in Jesus' name. May our dignity be restored in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Song.
Remember me, O my Heavenly Father. Remember me, O my Heavenly Father. Remember me, O my Heavenly Father. I am before you seeking your face. Remember us, O our Heavenly Father. Remember us, O our Heavenly Father. Remember us, O our Heavenly Father. We are before you seeking your face.
And that brings us to the 11th station. Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus was nailed to the cross. That is a process of crucifixion. Crucifixion by nailing. There he made a sacrifice. He stretched his hands and offered himself to his Father. Jesus attached himself to that cross. He allowed himself to be attached, to be nailed to that cross. Remember, some years before that time, Jesus was using nails to fix pieces of wood together because he was helping his Father in the carpentry business of the family. But now, the same nail he used to fix the plants, to fix the planks, to fix the woods, the same nails are now used to fix Jesus to the wood. My dear brothers and sisters, when your car is broken down, you take it to the mechanic because he understands how to fix it. But when your life is broken down, when your life is in pieces, you need a nail from Jesus to fix you together. Why use this opportunity to pray for people whose lives are disintegrating, whose lives are in fragments, people that they have lost inner peace. They have lost peace completely. Everything is falling apart because the center cannot hold. When the center is in crisis, it means that Jesus is no more there because Jesus is the Prince of Peace. We're asking that Prince of Peace of Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6 to bring peace to the troubled waters in the name of Jesus. We're asking him to fix you, to fix your life, to fix your bones, to fix your health, to fix your finances with his nail. Let him fix you up. Let him fight your battle. Let him make a way for you where there's no way. Through his pains, may you have gains. I repeat, through his pains, may you have gains in the name of Jesus. Somebody has to give a pain for somebody to have a gain. Jesus has made that offering of pains that we shall receive gains. I pray that many that are passing through a season of crisis, a season at which life is in falling apart, where everything is falling into pieces, may he who fixed your body, who made you, fix you together. He is your mechanic. He is your doctor. Jeremiah chapter 8, verse 22 calls him the balm of Gilead, the physician. May he heal you. May he restore you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Song.
The fountain of life is flowing everywhere. Whosoever drinks shall never be thirsty again. The fountain of life is flowing everywhere. Whosoever drinks shall never thirst again. The fountain of life is flowing everywhere. Whosoever drinks shall never thirst again.
And that brings us to the 12th station. Jesus dies on a cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My dear brothers and sisters, at this point, our Lord Jesus is hanging on the cross. He is hanging on the cross. The cross is on the mountain of Calvary. The mountain Calvary is at the outskirts of the city of Jerusalem. That is where the people throw their trash. That is where the people have a heap of garbages, where people throw all their mess. Now, this is where Jesus is buried. This is where Jesus is crucified. And my dear brothers and sisters, I don't know if you have some trash in your life you want to throw away. We are going to the outskirts of the city of Jerusalem. We are going to the Calvary, mountain of Calvary. We are going to drop that trash at the feet of Jesus. That situation, that mess, those things that are causing our tears, those crises, that sickness, that poverty, whatever it is, bring it to the feet of Jesus. This is the solution ground. This is our mountain Zion. Obadiah chapter 1 verse 17 says that on this mountain Zion, there shall be healing, there shall be deliverance. There people shall possess their possessions. Yes, a great exchange is taking place right now. On this mountain, Jesus will take your death and give you life. On this mountain, he will take your poverty and give you wealth and give you riches. On this mountain, he will take your weakness and give you strength. This is where the greatest exchange in life is taking place. The greatest trade by barter is taking place right now. Do you have something to exchange? Do you have something to trade? Now, bring it to the Lord now. As you are pouring to the Lord, as you are dropping it to Jesus, he is going to give you the opposite. And as you are doing this, I invite our sister to give us songs. Yes, my Lord. Father, we bring our problems to you. We lay them at your feet. Father, take control.
He that has saved my life, the death of Jesus set me free. He that has saved my life, the wounds of Jesus healed my life. He that has saved my life, the death of Jesus set me free. He that has saved my life, the wounds of Jesus healed my life. He that has saved our life, the death of Jesus set us free. He that has saved our lives, the wounds of Jesus healed our life. He that has saved our lives, the death of Jesus set us free. He that has saved our lives, the wounds of Jesus healed our life. He that has saved our life, the death of Jesus set us free. He that has saved our lives, the wounds of Jesus healed our life. He that has saved our lives, the death of Jesus set us free. He that has saved our life, the wounds of Jesus healed our life.
Father, touch your people. Papa, touch your people. Papa, touch your people. Who can change their ugly situations if not you? Who will wipe their tears if not you? Father, on this mountain, Father, take the trash of your people and give them treasure. Father, O Lord, take the trash of your people and give them triumph in the name of Jesus. Father, take the trash of your people and give them good. Father, Lord, Father, as your people are here, Father, let them possess their possessions in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, may you appear in the situations of your people through the blood coming out from the side of Jesus. May healing begin to take place now through the blood coming out from the hands and the feet of Jesus. May people begin to be delivered now. People that their hands are nailed or feet are nailed, such that they cannot move forward in life because they are nailed down. They cannot accomplish anything because their hands are nailed. I am praying for them now, Father, in the power of your name. Let them be delivered now. Father, deliver them now by the power of your name. In the name of Jesus, through the blood of Jesus, let salvation come. For the Bible says, Revelation chapter 12, verse 11, by the blood of Jesus, by the blood of the Lamb, they overcome the enemy. Father, heal them now. In the name of Jesus, you are our life. You are our God. Father, touch your people. Change their ugly situations. Every record, record of timidity, record of fear, record of failure, record of barrenness that have been written against your people. Father, I cancel now in the name of Jesus. Oh, Masharabu Sekereba. Oh, Maya Kendarabu. Father, 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 touch. Father, deliver your people by the power of your name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Oh, Lord and my God. You're the miracle worker, the Lord who answers when we call. You're the miracle worker, oh Lord and our God. You're the miracle worker, the Lord who answers when we call. You're the miracle worker, miracle worker, miracle worker. Miracle worker, you are the miracle worker. Miracle worker, miracle worker, miracle worker, you are the miracle worker. Oh Lord and God, you are the miracle worker, the Lord who answers when we call. You're the miracle worker, oh Lord and our God. You're the miracle worker, the Lord who answered when we called. We're the miracle worker.
Jesus, mighty God, the ancient of days, you are the miracle worker. We'll give you all the glory in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Father. And that brings us to the 13th station. Jesus, the body of Jesus is taken down from the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My dear brothers and sisters, as Jesus was taken down from the cross, we are praying for ourselves. That anything in life that is hanging us on a tree of shame, on a tree of failure, on a tree of weakness in prayer, on a tree of unforgiveness, may God, through this 13th session, bring us down to our senses. As the prodigal son came back to the Father, may we come back to him. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Song.
All glory must be to the Lord, for he is worthy of our praise. No man on earth will give glory to himself. All glory must be to the Lord. All glory must be to the Lord. For he is worthy of our praise. No man on earth should give glory to himself. All glory must be to the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. And that brings us to the 14th station. Jesus is laid in the tomb. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
My dear people of God, this is where Jesus was buried. And here we are burying our trash. We are burying our problems. We declare them buried now in the name of Jesus. We declare the burial site of Jesus, the burial ground, for all these things causing us our pains and sorrow. May all of them be buried. Every spirit attacking my family, attacking my destiny, let them be buried. Every opposition in my life, let them be buried. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Song.
We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jehovah Almighty. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Daddy. We thank you, Jehovah Almighty. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Daddy. We thank you, Jehovah Almighty. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jehovah Almighty.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, our God and our Father, for all that you have done in the course of this night's prayer. We give you all the glory. We claim our blessings. We claim our testimonies. And we decree that they are permanent. And that no power of the devil shall thwart our blessings or scatter our testimonies. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. The singing ministry was soaking the blood of Jesus. May God bless and protect each and every one of us. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Amen and amen.